what's up guys, in this video I'm gonna show you the best deck for the global tournament right now, and I think it's this Hawk Rider Psychic deck. I think I already shared a video on that deck. It's so strong in demons. You have the Infernatar, you have the White Livery and the Lock against all the bait components, against all the beatdown decks. Then you have the Spear Gobs and the bats, like for a really cheap cycle for baiting out the Zap. Knight is a tank against all the Witch Spam opponents. And then you have the Earthquake, one of the best cards in the game for all the buildings. And even against Magic Archer, Magic Archer dies from Earthquake Lock, so really good. Spell in general does like 2-0-4 damage, so a lot of damage as well, even more than a fireball. If you don't want to miss any videos in the future, don't forget to subscribe and don't forget to put code MORT in the shop if you guys want to support me. Thank you so much for everyone who is doing that, and I'm gonna see you in the first global tournament game. Let's go. Okay, see you in the first game, and the first tip I'm gonna give you is always don't play all your games at one day. I would always go like to 15 to 10, and then at the last day I would grind a lot. So my I got a tournament, I think I have it here. I got the emote already, and I think I did like just 5 games at the first day, then to 15-0 in the second game day, and then the third day I grinded really hard to get the emote. So I would suggest you don't do all your games at one day. So he's gonna play like an interesting thing. He has Bowler, Wizard. Okay, I think we're just gonna Infernatar here. Let's see how he's gonna answer. To that, we have the Hawk right already. We could go with a Hawk in the left of lane. Okay, he's gonna go with a Hawk as well, so I think we are gonna do the same here. We are gonna play Void Delivery on that. Void Delivery is killing everything, and at the same time, we have a really good counter push. I'm just gonna play a Log in case he's gonna go with Goblins. Unfortunately not, but still fine. I think we're just gonna go with Spear Gobs over here, and we have a really solid position here, okay. So with this deck, you normally just want to chip away with Hawk Rider and then try to cycle your opponent. You have such a fast cycle. You have the bats, you have the Spear Gobs, you have the Log, you have the Knight, the Void Delivery, so really fast cycle. And you cannot cycle every opponent. You always want to apply a lot of pressure and single elixir time and double. Double even more, like you can always apply aggression with this deck because you have the Infernatar and even you have the Void Delivery. Like one of the best cards in the game, you can make like such a good positive elixir trades against like Sparky minions push or like Sparky or like Giant Double Prince push. It's like so good in defense. It's like a Valkyrie, like a Valkyrie Dark Prince combination, so it's really good and it's like killing the charge. So we're just gonna go from Hawk, we're gonna log the princess here, and we're gonna play high bets. He has Zap, so we have to be careful with that. And we're just gonna play a knight here. Two. Okay, I didn't misclick because he played it in the middle, so you can kite it over. If you play it outside, you can't play the Infernatar like that. I think I'm gonna go for Hawk Rider as well because he doesn't have Bowler and Cycling. That's what I mean. For sure your opponent has the Bowler against one of your Hawk Riders, but not against two, not against every Hawk Rider you play. So we're gonna go with bats over here. And now we're gonna go with Void Delivery, we're gonna go with that, we're gonna go for Preemptive Lock because he has to play Bowler and Goblins, and we're gonna win the game right here. For sure he's not playing like the best deck in the game right now, but he had some solid answers, but we just outcycled him, and we have the Infernatar in defense, which is really, really good card, doesn't matter right now, against all the Lava, against all the Balloon decks. I really like to have Infernatar, one of my favorite cards at the same time. I really enjoyed the Infernatar meta. I think it was CL Spring Season 2019, and I'm gonna see you in the next global tournament game. What's here right now? Let's go. Okay, see you in the next game against Yui Hatano. Okay, we don't have like Hawk in starting end, so with this deck you can do everything. You can cycle Knight, and Knight in the back I'm not a really big fan because if you play against Expo you might have a problem, but bats, Spear Gobs, Log, always a good play, or like even Hawk Rider. So we're just gonna log cycle here, because I don't want to play my knight. And then wait until 10 elixir, and then we're gonna go with an Hawk right over here. We have Earthquake ready. And he is gonna play a wizard. Okay, bro, it's wizard time. So we're gonna go with Spear Gobs in the back and gonna play a knight in front to protect it. And at the same time, that's like a really nice thing about it. Like sometimes I know the opponent doesn't have like a baby dragon cycle or doesn't have Zap. I got a lot of towers already with this deck with just Knight Spear Gobs, with Knight Baby Dragon. So that's like a really nice combination with this deck that you don't have like just Hawk Rider, you have the Knight and Bats combination in the mind, like in the minor poison deck as well. So I really like to have it, and it's like so, so strong. I think I'm gonna go for Hawk Rider over here. He's gonna go for Ram Rider. Okay, that's kind of unfortunate. Okay, with Mini Pack as well. So our Hawk won't break through for sure. We're gonna go for Spear Gobs over here. Spear Gobs are doing an insane job. with the Infernatus cleaning up everything, and he has like the mini packer. He has the Ramrider, so he has like really solid answers, like mini, like Ramrider's killing the Hawk Rider, like for 5-4 trade. At the same time, you have a counter push, so one of the best Hawk counters as well, because at the same time as defensive and value, it gets like a counter push potential. So we're gonna go with bats over here. What is he gonna answer with? Oh, he's playing so passively. We're gonna go for knight over here just to make sure the Babylon is gonna be in tower range. And then we're gonna wait a bit. And I go, think we're gonna go for Hawk right here because he outside this mini packer and his Rembrandt. So with the earthquake ready in case he's gonna go for the skeleton army or something, he's not. And that's what I mean. He uses two counter cards against my Hawk Rider already, so we outcycled him. And that's like the thing, most of the time you play some Hawk Rider not to get damage, just to outcycle the opponent, let him spend a lot of elixir, let him spend a lot of cards, and with the next Hawk Rider you try to get damage. That's like always my thought process in most of the games. So I'm gonna go for Hawk Rider. He has to play a wizard here because he doesn't have anything else. Oh, he has a mini picker. Get him Psychic, so we're just gonna get play a Fair Tower down here. And the Fair Tower's getting so much value, killing the baby dragon, that we can place. Okay, we're just gonna go for Royal Delivery over here. Gonna play that. And this is like really good defense. We're gonna go for a Hawk Rider over here. We're gonna play an Earthquake because it's gonna play skeletons. Oh, he has to play skeletons or a wizard. Then we're gonna log. That's gonna be Tower down 2-0 for this episode. And I would say we're just gonna play a Fair Tower over here. That I'm gonna see you in the next game. Really nice game so far. For sure, like not the best opponents, but we're in the start of a global tournament. If you want to grind for another top 100 finish, I'm gonna see you next game. Let's go. See you next game against Fernando. We have the Hawk Rider on the starting end. We have the Spear Gobs, we have the Log. Perfect starting hand. We're just gonna start off with an Hawk. Well, he's gonna go for Knight, so it could be Hawk as well. And it looks like it could be a Hawk Mirror matchup, but here's the Bomb Tower version. I would prefer to have the Bomb Tower wish in the Mirror matchup because Bomb Tower is way better against the Q in my opinion, and it has one elixir cheaper. So if he's gonna go for Hawk now, we have to play Infernator, and we're gonna play the Spirits on the other side because he's gonna go with an Earthquake most likely. Okay, he's not. Oh, he's gonna play a Zap. Okay, he has Zap in it. That's interesting. What are we gonna do now? He's gonna go with Hawk Bats because he doesn't have Zap, he doesn't have Bomb Tower. That's what I mean without cycle the opponent, and now we're getting a ton of damage in. But like two hits, okay, I know his variation now. I know. He has the log variation with Zap. Okay, I think we're gonna go for Knight. We're gonna try to push it back. Hopefully it's not gonna get any hits here. Good. Push back by us. And we're gonna be in a good position right now because he still has to defend the recruit, because otherwise he's gonna get two hits on his tower. I don't think he wants to take that. He has to lock that and still one hit, and we're gonna go with Spear Gobs at the bridge. Just be aggressive. If he's gonna zap right now, we have the bats, we have the zap bay. So really solid position for us. I think we're gonna go with bats and Hawk, and we're gonna EQ for sure his Bomb Tower now. Let's go. He has to play a knight as well. And that's what I mean. We get such a good elixir trade out of him. He has to play a knight, he has to play the goblins, he has to play the Bomb Tower, so really solid offense by us. And we got the tower damage like 204 with the earthquake, as I said already. So I think we're gonna go for lock here just to cycle, getting some chip damage in. And then we're gonna go with Spear Gobs at the bridge. And we're gonna go for the Fat over here. He could earthquake that. Okay, he is. And I think right now we can earthquake that. He's gonna get one Hawkins. Can we get two Hawkins? Okay, that was worth it. I knew he has to spend the earthquake plus a zap offensively. That's why he was kind of low on elixir. I could have went with a preemptive lock there, but that's fine. That's fine. He's gonna lock it most likely. Oh, he's not. Okay, we have everything in defense right now. We have the White Lee, we have the Infernator, so we are chilling. We're gonna lock that first to get like jump chip damage on the Hawk. We're gonna play White Lee high. Oh my goodness, that's so good. He's not gonna get any hits here. We get like a really spicy counter push. I think we're gonna go with bats over here. Gonna play a Q over here. And even if not like getting the Hawk to the tower, we got a ton of ship damage. I think we're gonna go for World Delivery defensive plus bats because we know he doesn't have 7 cycle anymore. So it just should be one hit. Okay, fine. And then we're gonna go with Hawkins again. He is gonna play his Bomb Tower. The one bat is surviving and getting some chip on. Good goblins by him. Gonna play a log here, and we just try to outcycle. Now we need one more log, one more earthquake, and we're gonna win the game. Then we're gonna go for PM before I deliver here. And that's fine. We're gonna go for Infernal Tower. He won't be able to defend that. We're gonna go for Log over here on the tower. Gonna play Earthquake, I mean, gonna play a Log, and we're gonna win the game. We're gonna do one more game. Really nice game. Let's go. Let's have a next game against an Asian opponent. Okay, we're just gonna wait here, and then we're gonna go with a Log first. Okay. Could be Giant Gravel, could be Giant Sparky. Giant Gravel is a tough matchup. Giant Sparky is not that bad. So we're gonna go for Hawk Rider here. I hope it's not Giant Graveyard, because they have like double small spell against you, and you have just against Graveyard, you have the Log for sure, the White Lily, but the White Lily you most of the time need to play it against bats. He's gonna play Weed Golem. Okay, could be Golem. Yeah, okay, Golem Bomber maybe. Yes, for sure, Golem Bomber. It's like a normal deck as well. A lot of players are playing it in the top 200, and it looks like it's gonna be Golem. I hope he doesn't have Lightning. I really hope he doesn't have Lightning, so I think we're gonna go over here. Gonna play Void Delivery on the Night Bridge. Gonna lock that back. I hope we're not getting too much chip in. Oh, he's getting some damage in. We're gonna play Bats over here just to kill this. I hope some of the bats are surviving. No, okay, bro. But we're still gonna hog because he's low on Elixir. He played the Skeleton Army like okay. So we're gonna pressure him. That's not gonna be easy. He has the. Oh man. Okay, that's gonna be a really tough matchup because if he's gonna build up a big push, it's gonna be tough for us to defend. I think I'm gonna go with a defensive knight over here just to pressure him a bit that he can't golem once again. He has the zap, he has the tornado defense against the Hawk Rider. Okay. I think we just might have locked. We have to lock that. We're gonna lock that. He could go with Golem in front of that. He's gonna go, so we're gonna pressure opposite lane immediately. What's he gonna do now? He has to zap that. Okay, he has Nader once again in cycle. It's fine. White Delivery on that. It's fine. Oh my, that was a really nice White Delivery to be honest. No, they can't. I'm gonna go with Spear Gobs over here and we're gonna go for Hogwild. If he's gonna go with Skeleton Army, I'm gonna EQ that. Because then I don't get too much damage. And that's gonna be like a lot of Hog hits, but we spent a ton of Elixir, so won't be too easy to defend that. Here, lock. Good defense. Oh my goodness, that was a really solid defense by us. Okay. I think I'm gonna go with an Hawk right now. I think he's gonna. What is he gonna do? Gonna EQ once again. He has tornadoed still. And even if a tornado, it's gonna be one hit. I think we should take it up right now. We're gonna lock here just to cycle a bit. Gonna play Bats at the Bridge just to pressure him that the Night Bridge is gonna die. Then we have another Hawk and he can't defend Hawk EQ right now. Even for Mini Packer, it's gonna be one hit. We are gonna win the game. It wasn't an easy matchup. We were able to win it. If you guys don't wanna miss any videos in the future, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. I hope the tips helped you a bit. And I'm gonna see you in the next game. For you right now, I hope I can finish top 100 once again. Peace out. See you in the next one.